In September 2018, 30-year-old Amber Guyger fatally shot Botham Jean in his Dallas, Texas apartment as he was eating a bowl of ice cream. He had just come home from work 30 minutes before the shooting. Botham was a 26-year-old native of the Caribbean island of St. Lucia. He was a graduate of Harding University and worked in Dallas for the accounting and consulting firm PricewaterhouseCoopers.
He didn't deserve that. He was such a sweet boy in his home. How can we move on without him? Fine. But we will try. We will remember him. His legacy will live on.
Guyger, who was a Dallas police officer at the time and still in her uniform, claimed it was self-defense. She said she feared for her safety when she entered the apartment, believing it was her home, and found the door unlocked. Guyger said she spotted Jean in the dark apartment, thought he was an intruder, and shot him with her service gun when he failed to obey her command to put his hands up.
And the figure was moving around as you described?
Yes, I have my gun pointed, and I'm saying, let me see your hands, let me see your hands.
What were you focused on?
Him.
Just him?
Yes.
And then he began coming towards you?
Yes.
And as he became coming toward you, that's when you heard him speak?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to do that now, all right?
Yes, sir.
Hey!
And that's at that point whenever I shot.
Somewhere in this area?
Yes.
When you shot, what happened?
He fell down.
On the 911 call and later when police arrived, she is heard repeatedly saying, quote, I thought it was my apartment, end quote.
I thought it was my apartment. I thought it was my apartment. I thought it was my apartment. I thought it was my apartment.
And what's the gate code there?
I don't know.
You don't know? Okay.
I thought it was my apartment.
They're trying to get in there. We have an officer there. You don't know the gate code?
No. I thought it was my apartment.
Okay, and what floor are you in right now?
The fourth.
She wasn't immediately arrested, which drew a lot of criticism from Botham's family. The police stated that it was merely to gather evidence and investigate appropriately. After bringing in the Texas Rangers for additional support, Amber was arrested for manslaughter and placed on administrative leave. During the trial, the defense claimed that she was experiencing a high level of fatigue when she drove to her apartment. This caused her to accidentally park on the fourth floor of the garage instead of the third. She then walked up to what she believed was her door, and when she went to place the keys in the lock, the door pushed open. The prosecution painted a very different picture. Texts were shown to the jury that showed Guyger messaging her patrol partner illicit things she wanted him to do to her. John also had a very bright red doormat that would have been pretty hard to miss. Also, Botham's body was found near the couch, and it didn't seem like he had enough time to lunge at her as she stated. Prosecutor Jason Fine said, quote, It's not a mistake. It's a series of unreasonable decisions. Nobody had to die. She caused his death. She acted unreasonably. End quote. Guyger was found guilty of manslaughter. During the sentencing hearing, Botham's brother, Brant Jean, got on the stand and shocked the courtroom.
But I love you just like anyone else. And I'm not gonna say I hope you rot and die just like my brother did, but I personally want the best for you. And I wasn't gonna ever say this in front of my family or anyone, but I don't even want you to go to jail. Again, I love you as a person. And I don't wish anything bad on you. I don't know if this is possible, but can I give her a hug, please? Please?
Yes.
The trial created a lot of media attention, and the verdict was met with jeers and anger. Outside, a crowd chanted, "No justice, no peace." Guyger's attorneys asked the court to overturn her murder conviction during her appeal. They wanted to replace it with a conviction for criminally negligent homicide, a lesser charge that would carry a maximum punishment of 2 years in jail. That appeal was denied. Under Texas law, a person convicted of murder can be eligible for parole after serving half their sentence. That would mean Guyger could get her first parole hearing in 2024. Let me know your thoughts on this case in the comments below.